Yo, 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 it's your boy Three Stacks in this thing, baby, representing Team Kings of Games. I'm recording in the kitchen of the new place that me and my girl and our kids just moved into. This is just till we get the rest of our stuff in and get better and bigger furniture and everything. So kind of got to bear with me for this instance. But I'm showing you guys some hype stuff. I have to get my setup a little different before I go to sleep. So yeah, Shadals are getting a lot of hype, and you guys know I'm a Shadal Prediction Princess. Player, I'm still tweaking my list. I'm very, very on the fence of just playing pure because there's just so much more that you can do just with pure alone. In the turns that you can play a lot more Shadal cards and you can play the deck more the way it was supposed to be played. But when you're mixing it with other, you know, even with Invoked, it has synergy. But like pure is just kind of where I'm leading towards. But I'm showing you guys this combo that revolves with my Prediction Princess Shadals. But I'm not going to do any Ritual or Prediction Princess stuff in this combo. And just kind of show you guys some cool things you could do with the new Shadal cards. And this is my current list. So you're going to normal rescue count. Obviously, standard Shadal players don't play this. But again, this is Three Stacks list, not everybody else's. You're going to send your rescue cat out. You're going to special out your guard dog. And I was just trying to find out ways that I can fuse without opening a fusion spell, without having Alistair. So there's other conventional ways of playing Shadals without playing Invoke Shadals. This was my way of finding a way to pretty much turboing into Construct and then using Construct to summon the actual Construct, using that to dump any fusion spell, linking the Construct and the anything other monster to get the Construct grave to add the fusion spell that you dumped off Construct, then activate it, summon a second Construct. You know, use that Construct, dump the trap, and then you do your standard combo. It's just a lot of value. Where I was just finding, if you can find a way to summon Construct even without a Shadal fusion spell, you can use Construct herself to dump that fusion spell, which a lot of players forget about, and then use her herself to add it back. So she essentially adds any Shadal spell or trap from your deck to your hand as well, and she's not once returned. So this hand's going to summon Construct, and then you're going to be able to get a fusion spell if you want, but anyways, link the two guard dogs into Construct. Activate Shadal Construct's effect. You're going to fuse it and Windy into an actual Construct. And then you've got Chainlink 1, Chainlink 2. It doesn't really matter, actually, with the Chainlinks. So we'll go effect of Windy, special out Aerial, and then effect of Construct. You're going to dump the trap. And then what we're going to do here is we're going to activate Construct and Grave. Pitch Skamata, resummon this Construct, effective Skamata. Skamata is going to go ahead and send any Shadal, so what you'll want to do is send any Shadal fusion spell, obviously. And then you can go ahead and link the Construct, both Constructs, into any link, any generic. IP Mascarina is what I normally would go for, but I don't have one, so this could just be the IP Mascarina, and then effective Construct at the L. Or you can even make Cross Sweep if you have it. But normally, like if I'm trying to just set up interruptions, I go for an IP Mascarina. But we can say this is Cross Sweep, which I also don't have. So let's say this is Cross Sweep because it makes it even more insane. At the L off of the Construct, and then you're gonna activate Reincarnation, Banishing Construct, target the Aerial, flip the Aerial, Aerial effect, summon the Construct. And then you're going effect of Cross Sweep, effect the Construct, whatever your chain links you want them to be, doesn't really matter. What's important is you're going to be reborning a level 4. Make sure you do that so you can summon a rank 4. And then Construct's going to go ahead and dump. The next thing that you need is just names. So I would just dump a Hedgehog and use Hedgehog to get a Skamata, so that I have utility for whatever doll I need for the following play. And so you end up getting two cards back to your hand out of this. So you should your ending board, you should have this plus four cards. You can overlay these two in Cross Sweep zone into, you know, a Dweller. Or you can extend into Dugarris. It depends on the situation. But I like my standard Shadal combo. I normally end with the rank 4, which is going to be either Dweller, Dugarris, or Emerald. Those are my rank 4s of choice for right now. And you'd have the follow-up of Construct in your grave, this Construct. If you wanted to just go for Opelousa, you can go for Opelousa, so you could just leave these. And disrupt the graveyard too, Opelousa plus a graveyard disruption. You could just link the Cross Sheep, the Construct, and the Skamata into, you know, an Opelousa for 3. Leave the Aerial, set the L Shadal, and then summon Winda on their turn, banish 3 cards from their grave, hit them with the Winda. You know, you could do that as well. So there's different variations, there's different any boards, there's different sequences, but this is like a bread and butter combo. This is kind of like your full combo, if you would say, of opening no shit all fusion spells and still going off. That's the point I wanted to show you guys. And it's not just about shit all fusion spells, it's about me showing you guys how to open no fusion spells, period, and still go off. That's something that a lot of shit all players still have not figured out how to do. Main reason being is because they're not 3 stacks, they want to play mainstream, you know, net decking, kind of monkey see, monkey do. Since everybody sees everybody playing Invoke, nobody ever really considered, well, there has to be some other way to consistently get access to our fusions without playing other engines and still play pure shit all, for example, if you wanted to. I'm not saying you have to. Or even just without having to put more actual fusion spells in your deck. Well, that's one of many ways that you can do that. But essentially, the goal that I'm getting more towards is kind of Construct Turbo. So my list ideally is Construct Turbo once I get this Contra out. Because you guys have no idea how good this card actually is. On pen and paper, it looks worse than what it actually is. But this card's insane, especially with the new support. You want to make this as quickly as possible. Fuse it off, get it engraved, resummon it, open zones for yourself. Every turn, you're going to resummon this from grave and open zones for yourself. So this link is a lot better than you think, and I feel that any hand that can make this is insane. So yeah, that's a little combo tutorial, quote-unquote, so to speak. Not really a combo, but you guys kind of are getting my drift. Thank you guys so much for tuning into this video. If you guys are interested in my list for shit alls and stuff like that, you're definitely going to see it, but I still am tweaking, refining, and debating between 4 different variations of shit alls. I'm on the fence between these 4. Prediction Princess being one, Pure being the other, and the other 2 being some other stuff. I don't want to play Invoke shit-alls at all. That's what I don't want to do, period. It's not just about the I don't want to be monkey see, monkey do. It really is just like, I know that there's other and better ways of playing the deck. And even though Invoke is, it's tried and true, one thing I will say that you guys want to be cautious of, as me being a guy that loves to splash decks and other decks, and I play hybrids more than I would say anybody that I know. If you ever put an archetype inside of another archetype, you want to make sure that it doesn't share the same weaknesses. And one thing that Invoke and Shadows have alike is they share very similar weaknesses. They all do. And while Invoke can be a way to throw your opponent off, have them think you're playing Invoke, and they can hand trap that, and then you're like, bam, Shadows fusion. That's not enough for me, because they're both graveyard reliant. They both rely on your opponent typically having something, whether it's on the field or in the graveyard. That's how Invoked and Shadow rely. In addition to that, Abyss Dweller can shut down both archetypes. And on top of that, Dimensional Barrier completely cuts your deck off. It doesn't matter if you have Invoke cards or Shadow cards, Dimensional Barrier is turning your, it's just shutting your turn down. But with my list, I have ways to kind of circumvent from around that and fix that. And I have additional summoning mechanics, so I'm not just auto-losing to the same card. So that's one thing. Like, it's like, for example, putting Infernoids inside of an Orcus deck. You're already losing to Lancia. Why would you make your deck want to lose even harder to Lancia? Somebody understands what I'm talking about. So that's just my speculation and my theory and the reasonings behind not playing Invoke shit-alls. But to each his own, do whatever you want. And I'm not here to talk about which one's better. I'm just telling you which one I prefer to play. That's all. Period. Peace out, yo.